You want to learn how to safely land your helicopter without an engine in flight simulators like Microsoft Flight Simulator, DCS, or X-Plane? In this video, I'll teach you the basics of autorotations. In our last video, you learned how to hover, take off, land, and fly. But what if your engine dies mid-air? Will you plummet down to the earth like a brick? Well, not necessarily. This is where autorotations come in. In normal flight, your engine powers your rotor system, and your rotor generates lift. But when your engine dies, your rotor will start freewheeling and quickly lose lift. But in an autorotation, instead of the engine powering the rotor blades, the airflow flowing up through the rotor blades will start spinning the rotor instead. So you will have to maintain a steady airflow through your rotor, or you will still drop out of the sky. You need to react quickly and correctly. So building muscle memory is key. Today, we're going to practice a straight-in autorotation, which is the most basic and easiest type of autorotation that you can practice. Let's dive in. Welcome on board this UH-1H UE. This helicopter has quite a large rotor system, which makes it ideal for practicing autorotations because it retains a lot of energy. Whereas smaller rotors dissipate energy much faster when freewheeling because, well, that's just how physics work. In a moment, I'll reduce the throttle to simulate an engine failure. This will cut the power to the rotor system. And as soon as I do that, you will have to drop that collective to keep the airflow going. And be ready, because as soon as the engine stops powering the rotor, it will stop generating torque. So, if you have been applying anti-torque with the pedals, you'll need to ease off, as the torque effect will then be gone. However, you may still need minor pedal adjustments to maintain your heading. Okay, are you ready? Here goes the throttle. And drop the collective. As you can see on the inner circle of your RPM gauge, your rotor RPMs have dropped. Pull back on your cyclic a little bit to increase the airflow and quickly regain some rotor RPMs. Pitch for a steady airspeed. For most helicopters, 60 to 70 knots is a good target during descent, but always refer to your specific helicopter's flight manual for optimal autorotation speed. A higher airspeed gives you a longer glide, while a lower airspeed allows for a steeper approach. So adjust as needed based on your landing zone and helicopter type. Make sure your rotor RPMs are in the greens. Too high and you'll risk structural damage or lose control. Too low and you'll lose lift. Unless you want to impact the field, you do need to flare. So between 50 and 100 feet, gradually start flaring your helicopter to convert that forward airspeed in a little boost in RPMs. Your airspeed is now quickly falling, and so is your lift. So make sure you pull more collective to trade those RPMs for lift again and to cushion your landing. But always make sure to first level off, or otherwise your tail will hit the ground. As soon as you touch down, make sure you lower your collective to prevent structural damage or other things like dynamic rollover. But if you survived, congratulations, you survived! Yay! This was just one of the many types of autorotation. There are different situations where a shallow approach, like we just did, is not possible. For instance, your engine might fail during hover when you're low and slow. Or it might fail during takeoff when you are low and gaining speed. And then there are times when your landing space is limited, so your only option is to come in really steep. But no matter what predicament you're in, the only way to save your butt is to practice, practice, and practice. Just make sure you pick the right flight simulator and the correct helicopter module, because while some model autorotations pretty accurately, others fail miserably. So choose wisely. Well, I hope you learned something new. If you did and you liked the video, please leave a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, and hope to see you next time. Bye-bye.